Are there any questions? Okay, if not, we'll just continue here. This is Night Sounds. I'm Bill Pearce. Hi, welcome. I can almost see somebody's hand raised, saying, hey, I've got a question. A lot of them. What I need is an answer or two. I appreciate very much the privilege of joining you this way. And although I know it seems to be a one-way kind of input here, your response is delayed, so there is a cycle potentially. I've entitled my program tonight, What is the Question? And in a half hour's time, we'll not come up with all of the answers, or maybe even some of them. But we may strike on a question. All questions have answers, and of course the thing is to try to find exactly where they are and what they are. Questions like, what's going on in my life? Or, why is this happening to me? Or, where is God when I need Him? These are important questions. They've been asked by many people before you or me. In fact, even asked in song, such as our first music tonight by Joyce Landorf. Where are you?
Listen to my broken song.
Joyce Landorf, where are you? There were a couple of important questions in there. I don't know whether you noticed them. One of which was, why are you waiting so long? Maybe that's one of the questions you're into. Asking God why. Well, again, we're not the only ones asking questions like those. I'd like to direct your attention for just a moment here to an Old Testament book by a fellow with a funny-sounding name, Habakkuk. And in the first couple of verses of his writing, in chapter 1, he asked a question like Joyce asked a few moments ago and like perhaps you and I ask again and again. Habakkuk said, O Lord, how long must I call for help before you will listen? I shout to you in vain. There's no answer. I have a feeling when I read that he didn't shout it the first time. He probably started very laid back, asking God to help. The more frustrated he became, perhaps without any answers or visible ones, the louder he asked. Finally, he was shouting. Did you ever scream at the Lord in frustration? I have many times. Well, here's Habakkuk shouting in vain, he said. There is no answer. Help! Murder! I cry. But no one comes to save. Must I forever see this sin and sadness all around me? Wherever I look, there is oppression and bribery and men who love to argue and to fight. The law is not enforced, and there is no justice given in the courts, for the wicked far outnumber the righteous, and bribes and trickery prevail. These are the anxious questions of Habakkuk the prophet. Okay, here comes the reply. And we're reading tonight from Habakkuk in the Old Testament, chapter 1, in the paraphrased version. The Lord replied, Look and be amazed. You will be astounded at what I am about to do. For I am going to do something in your own lifetime that you will have to see to believe. I am raising a new force on the world scene, the Chaldeans, a cruel and violent nation who will march across the world and conquer it. They're notorious for their cruelty. And God goes on to further describe this rather tough vision. And Habakkuk replies in verse 12, O Lord my God, my Holy One, you who are eternal, is your plan in all of this to wipe us out? Surely not. O God, our rock, you have decreed the rise of these Chaldeans to chasten and correct us for our awful sins. We are wicked, but they far more. Will you, who cannot allow sin in any form, stand idly by while they swallow us up? Should you be silent while the wicked destroy those who are better than they? And he goes on to say in the first verse of chapter 2, I will climb my watchtower now and wait to see what answer God will give to my complaint. And God finally says in chapter 2, verse 3, But these things I plan won't happen right away. Slowly, steadily, surely, the time approaches when the vision will be fulfilled. So the main message of the moment here is future. God doesn't say, Look, here it is. You just don't see it. He said, You will be astounded at what I am about to do, or am going to do something in your own lifetime. I am now raising, so it's in process. And then, of course, Habakkuk gets the message. And he says, okay, I'll wait. I'll wait to see what answer will come to my complaint. And the Lord again has to say, you're not going to see it happen right away. Be patient. Maybe patience is the answer right now for you. And you and I might reply to that, well, okay, but it doesn't really seem to be the answer that I want. I want action. Well, the idea again is that action is in process. But some actions take time. We might say, yes, but I've waited a long time. God is in action. He is in control. And if you and I have given our lives to Him and bowed to His sovereignty and His timing and His methods, as Habakkuk, perhaps we better just climb our watchtower and wait. It's not wasted time. We're learning patience in the interim. We're learning forbearance. We're learning sensitivity. Perhaps developing some scar tissue along the way. A higher pain tolerance. And speaking of our subject tonight, what's the question? Some people are giving answers to questions that aren't being asked. Then again, there are questions real people are asking that aren't being answered because we're not listening to the questions. In his article in the Discipleship Journal, Jerry Harville said, "This discovery penetrates to the core of the church's contemporary mission. Perhaps the reason so many unchurched singles, battered divorcees, single parents, and individuals fighting chronic or terminal illness are not present on Sunday morning is that the church is not present to hear their questions on Saturday night. Is it so strange that life's walking wounded give up on the church, or even God, when their quest for help and healing is met with theological answers to questions they're not asking, or with answers coming from flawless people whose solutions carry little sense of the burden of real human struggle? And even well-meaning, sometimes insensitive, unaware Christians, Bibles in hand, are ready to refute any objection to faith in Christ. But are we answering the right questions?" Mr. Harville said, "A wise man once told me that if, as a teacher, I wanted what mattered to me to matter to my students, then what mattered to them had to first matter to me." I think that could be translated to us right here. I'm no teacher, I have no teaching license or credits. Nonetheless, God can speak through you or me to help teach each other. The day before this particular recording was made, I received a call from the west coast of the United States from my son, whom I hadn't heard from for a couple years. God had touched him in a real way and brought faith and deliverance and healing to his heart and mind and soul and spirit. And he called on the phone to help me. and to give me some answers to questions I had. So let's be ready for input and for some answers to questions we've been formulating but haven't voiced yet. And as God told Habakkuk, it's not going to happen right away. Then again, it may happen moment by moment as we step out in faith. Believing is seeing. That's what our next music is all about, from the Hamiltons. Minute by minute.
Not the words that I say, not the deeds that I do, not the songs that I sing, these alone just won't do. Not by giving my all that I see in need, not by telling to men you're ready and willing to lead, but it's minute by minute, day by day, giving my life over, Lord, to you. Oh, it's minute by minute, day.
Husband and wife team singing there, a song of continuum, minute by minute. And you're in tune with Night Sounds, just in case you were wondering. My name is Bill Pearce, and we come by your place just about every night at this time, on this station. And how I appreciate the radio stations that program Night Sounds. Night after night, week after week, month after month, year after year, sometimes decade following decade. Faithful staff, management of radio stations reaching out to hurting people in their area. Why don't you take a few moments, if you just happen to have them, maybe even tomorrow, write to your radio station. Thank them for what they're doing. I'm sure they'll appreciate it. And it'll do you good to exercise yourself in that way. Speaking of writing, while you have pen in hand, and if you can find another stamp, I'd love to hear from you too. If we can be of help to you in any way that we're able, we're ready. By prayer support, standing with you, being a friend, sending information, materials, programs, information of the Night Sounds Treasury. Our mailing address for any or all of this information is Night Sounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. While that last recording was playing, it occurred to me that I think the next program I do on Night Sounds will be entitled, What's the Answer? Since tonight's program is called What's the Question? Speaking of the question, what is the question that people, unbelievers, are asking of us? Those who say we are Christians. One counselor said, my years of listening to university students, as well as personal experience, have shown me a couple of core questions today's unbelievers are asking, one of which is a sense of self. How do I find it? Hungering for a sound and healthy sense of self. They're also seeking a sense of reality. A sense of what is real, what is authentic, what is bona fide, valid, to make sense out of the confusion outside. Another question, where is beauty? In a wounded world, beauty is a rare element. How about a sense of mystery in the midst of a scientific high-tech world? These are just some of the questions. They may sound pretty general, but they can be very specific. And they uncover a lot within each and every one of us that needs an answer. A sense of identity, certainly, and purpose is involved in all of this, too. To find something stronger, more meaningful, eternal, outside of ourselves. Here's Kurt Kaiser, pianist, playing a song he wrote with the title His Will, Our Own. This is Imperative. Kaiser, beautiful song, His Will, Our Own. As we're thinking tonight of questions, what's the question that faces you that's uppermost in your mind and heart? If it's important to you, it's important to us. And what matters to you matters to me, because we're all looking for meaning in our lives. And education and wisdom that goes beyond just book learning. To know God is the beginning of wisdom, the fear, reverential trust of the Lord. We're going to close tonight with a little soul music for you. This may rattle your bones a bit, but it's got some real delving, meaningful content to it. I want to be more like my Jesus, moment by moment, day by day, tomorrow, the next day, the next, and the next. Every day. be more like my Jesus every day, every hour, every moment. Oh Lord, we give ourselves to you. We have so many questions. You have the answers. Help us to look to you, to your word, to wait on your spirit, and learn patience if needs be. Whatever you see is the most needful for us, this is what we want, to be better people for you. In Jesus' name, amen. Thanks for being there. Hope we can do this again via radio next time on Nightsounds. Till that moment, a good day to you tomorrow, and good night.